And that's why we the famous Rock of Ages, made a mandatory that every month, and since that last day to today, we have come to that. That all these women must have their blood, their BP, malaria treatment, telephone, and their sugar level. We have all their data. So make sure we follow them up. We don't want to lose anyone again. Your life is more important to us in as much as we are pursuing to save your children. And that's why, from this healthcare, we make sure, please, and if you're here, you're a widow, and when the time, as some of them are already going through the process now, please make sure before you go, you have your medical card, make sure you go through your process and collect your drugs, please, as you leave today. So my brothers and sisters, those are here, I say today is not where we are not going to talk much. But the evidence of what we are seeing today is what I personally struggled on my effort. I've not received any support from any government. No organization has given any funding. No body, no person has ever given any funding. It has been on my personal effort. And this is the 68th I am doing it. Somebody may ask me why. I grew up just like every Nigerian as a hustler. But my beginning was very tough. Very rough and very tough. I remember I served my master in Borno State, as I always say, for 10 years and 9 months. In all his effort to settle me, I was given 15,000 for my 10 years of apprentice. When I was hoping I would get up to about 1 million or 2 million, I was given 15,000. And it was, to me, a shock, but with the situation at hand, I had no option. I depended on God and I was walking along the street of Borno. If I'm walking, I keep on asking myself a question, is this how I will survive? But one day, an event happened that changed my story. And what was that that happened? There was a program going on in the Kennedy Stadium in Maiduguri. As a young Catholic, I take care of the children who are called the Blood Rosary Crusade. So I was taking these children home, and suddenly I saw the floodlight on the Kennedy Stadium. And then I asked someone to say, there is prayer going on, crusade going on there. And then I decided to go there and pass night. Since where I was sleeping, I don't have a dog, it's nylon. I used to have my dog. And to make the matter worse, I don't even have a mat, it's a carton. So I decided to go there and then pass the night till Sunday morning. It was on Saturday. And while I get into the venue, the man that was preaching on that program came out and made a statement. He said, if you are here, every money you have in your pocket, break it out. I will pray for you. When you go back to your business on Monday, you will be blessed. I said, thank God this man don't say I need blessing that bad. After about 15,000, we trade on spare parts. I have a small locker where I sample my small hydraulic blocks and contact. So I had made about 8,000 blocks. I said to myself, okay, the best thing is, let me receive a prayer from this. And then by Monday, I believe it's going to be well. So when I raised the money, what I had in my pocket was about 8,200 and something. I raised the money up, the man prayed. And after the prayer, and while he was praying, I was crying. I said, God, if you will bring me out of this problem, I will help the poor. While at that time, my mom was late, so and my family had nothing to refer the poor. So while I was crying, the man finished the prayer. And then on the steps of the Kennedy field and volleyball field, I looked. The man was shaking as I'm talking. And the man couldn't talk. Everyone was silent. He now said, that money you raised up that I prayed with you is for you. It's no longer your money. He said, this thing I'm telling you, if you will do it, you will escape from poverty forever. I said, amen. He said, that money is no longer your money. Drop it as an offering. I said, child.
How can I draw 8,000?
No, this man didn't see well. Because if this man they see vision, if one knows, say, this is my home and I'm wrong money. But suddenly, I had battles within my spirit. But the voice said to me, Newman, if you miss it, you have missed it. The way I tied the money in the nylon, I just took the money and dropped it. There was one preacher that came with that man, they called me, what's it, Dandara? I can't remember, no, they are links again. But you know, my brothers and sisters, I returned back home, walking, Sunday I have to pray, eat in people's houses. On Monday I just came, I was laying down like this on top of my locker. And suddenly somebody came and knocked. And said, Newman, sleeping on duty at this early morning. I said, I'm just preparing to pray for today's business. It's okay, till evening. When he said till evening, that man was a big man. I don't have any link with him at all. And when I got up to leave in the evening, the man called me back and said, I said to you, come. I went, the man gave me 300,000. And I know you will succeed. He gave me 300,000. I said, for what? He said, do use it for your business. Anything, anytime I need it, I'll tell you. Wow. I have two options in me. The place where I'm sleeping, there is no door. How will I carry 300,000 to go and sleep in that house? It's a problem. Now, should I carry it to the place where we normally do our block grocery? It's a problem. Children can play where I can lose the money. In fact, right there, I take a decision to travel. And I left my book read that evening down to Newman with them. See another miracle. I got there, submitted my list to the company. So many people came to check their things. The man supplied. And after the supply, they gave me the list of 940,000. I said, Jay, what I'm here with is 300,000. Separate the money, give me the one my money reach. Let me break it away. Give me the one my money is equal to. The man looked and said, how can this boy take this things back? Carry all of them. When you reach, send the money to me. 940,000. I'm getting close to a million already. On my arrival to the degree, those materials were not in the market. I packed them in people's shop. Within 1 week, I finished all. I called the man said, okay, don't worry yourself. Just make sure what you need, the company will supply. And the company supply. And here I am today. If you are here listening to me, there is no level where God cannot take you to. Never you give up. Never you lose hope. I started the journey without nothing. And for this is the sixth year. Every year in our budget is 25 million on my own. Some people ask me, this is 6 years, how do I get the money? Because when I cried to God and said, God, if you help me, I will help the poor. One day, the women, the widows in our church had a challenge. I have to beg God, please help me to get the thing for this woman. I did it, and before you know it, I forgot what I promised God. And he drew my intention back. And when he drew my intention back, you know, I have written up about 11 books, and I will 9 of them to these students. And that's why every proceeds that comes from these books, anywhere I go to preach, is what you are seeing here today. That's where I've been raising the money and taking care of these people for the past 6 years. But now I see that it's no longer what I will carry alone because widows are increasing. It may interest you to know that we, all these men are learning most of the things you are seeing here that will be given out today. Initially, when we do finish, we will still give them money. But today, you see what they have learned. Most of these things they were there, but I go the training to be giving to them. I don't charge them one kobo. you are not bringing one farthing. Nobody has not come to you and said you bring me one naira. The cry of my heart is always this: let these women be happy. If they are happy, that's my job. I want to say to you, welcome to this year, and I say to you, thank you for honoring our invitation. And that's why we are begging, pleading seriously, especially for our government to help us. We have been looking, these widows don't need much. A little hand, a little, just 5,000, 10,000, they can turn it around. Some of them that were giving 20,000, 10,000, within 6 months came back and told me, I'm making it 120, 150,000. Give it for me. I know several times we have written to the government demanding for land for them to, for agriculture. We want them to eat this agriculture, they invest in this agriculture. I tell you, vegetable is what you can farm now, harvest again, plant again. They don't need even to move around begging. It's as simple as we have gone and then all our efforts to see that we will get that from government. Well, when government couldn't get, we decided to go and be leasing land. What I discovered that these women you are seeing, they are wonderful. They are not lazy. They are not lazy at all. I discovered that the best person to give money to train children, give it to a woman. If you give a man, I'm not away. But give money to a woman, she will give that money, utilize that money. Women, you are wonderful. I said to them, you are wonderful. If you agree with me, clap for yourself, please. One of them brought me some vegetables and said to me, Daddy, hey, I'll be looking at them, I'll be seeing how they make this effort from nothing. From nothing. From nothing. And that's why we are begging even the government if they can help us get land for us, let these women, portion land for these women, these people, let them move into it and then farm. They'll be bringing their own. My intention and desire is that by next year, if we're able to get enough land, we will have a trade fair for widows. Where they will bring all these their farm products. Let people come and buy. If you will like it, can I hear you say yes? So that people will come and buy the things you have produced from your farm, and then we'll rejoice with them. In absence of this, I say to you all, thank you for coming to be with us. Thank you for coming to us. And God bless you all. Thank you.
Together for yourselves. You are all beautiful. E to the X to the P, expensive itself. Any other one to say? All right, without taking much of your time, maybe we do the thing. Sorry, I didn't speak English. We do sponsor. All right, maybe we do the thing the way we did one. I mean, in one room, I will understand very well. Okay, I see Madam Patient Ozokwa. Please put your hands together for her. Hold on. I don't know if I got a mama G, whether I will stand here. Yes, the children they know they got a mama G, not true. Anyway, she will correct that one today. We will know the truth. All right. But when we use the devil, they know I'm gonna have it. AKA Mama. To give the key address, this beautiful money, please let's put our hands together for Mrs. Patience Ozokwa, aka Mama G. Please put your hands together for her. Mrs.
of honor.
Yes.
I need to my fellow widows, I need to now. When I lost my husband, people were coming to condo with me. They were encouraging me. And one woman came to me and said,
Okay.
The kite cannot carry me. That there had been widows before me. If the kite has not been able to carry them and throw them away, that I should say that nothing will happen to me. And I was encouraged. The kite can carry a chicken. The kite can carry a lizard. But the cat cannot carry you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to tell you something. It is good to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is good to praise the Lord. They go ahead and collect so much money from international bodies, They collect money from government here. They collect money from individuals. They say they are launching their NGO. And they collect this money, and the money will not even get to the nearest person to them. But here is a man who God has blessed. The reason God blesses you is for you to bless the next person. I know a man in Anambra State. This man, I will not call his name, but his words are speaking for him. Anytime he comes home, his father will tell him, there's a family I just discovered, they are suffering. This man built a beautiful house. And he said to himself, I will never allow any rubbish house to be around me. So all the people that are his neighbors, he will look at them and build a good house for them. We have such people. They are in our midst, just like our brother here. He is in our midst. And that is why you can look around now and see beautiful things. These are the kind of people I like working with. And I would like to be like them. And I look at the things here. There are not things that are worth, like, you know, sometimes even in the church, when they say, bring something for the less privileged, people will go and bring the dresses that are gone, the things that they no longer use, television that is spoiled, they go and repair it. Am I lying?
No!
These ones are still in the catalog, tear over. If you have who, go give. If you have, they are not. start to know what to do. Don't give up blowing the trumpet in the village. Even, I know I don't have many. What I have, I share with her. That is even why she was able to eat today. We don't want to hear it. The reason we do such one in public is to encourage others who have little money to make out time and listen to the voice of these women. The men, most of the time, can survive this kind of situation, but the women, it is difficult for them. Especially when it comes to Christian women. Because the Bible says that you have the right to remarry if you want to. But if you don't want that, you must be a widow indeed. Who is a widow indeed? A widow indeed is a woman who has lost her husband and has decided to stay for her children. Without looking at another man or bringing him in. Because when you are in your house as a widow and you bring another man, your children are looking at you.
Alive next year, he will do more.
Yeah. If he dies, district senator, distinguished member of the House of Reps, if you are the governor, if you are the head of this country, and you are not looking at the widows, God help you, Jesus name. But anybody that looks our way, I am saying what God says I should say. If you are angry, forgive me. But I must say it. If you pass stand on me, I will go outside there and dust it out. And wash it. And take my bath. And come back and continue to say it. If you pour hot water on me, I will go and treat it. When it heals, I will still come back and say what I'm saying. To my brother who is a senator, to my brother who is a member of the House of Reps, to my brother who is a governor, member of the House of Assembly, anything, commissioner, minister, all this, I don't care. That thing you are doing, if it's not affecting the lives of these masses that voted for you, God will judge. You have a right to judge. Now, GCK,
God Almighty. We are apart from Mama
it's you.
Although, let me let the emotion that in my capacity as the grand partner of this foundation, I would like to give her another G. What I mean by another G is that if you all agree and you accept my proposal, let me call her Mama Global General. Those who support my motion, please say aye. Those against, say nay. Mama, I have the pleasure to inform you that from now onwards, you are Mama Gigi. And Mama Gigi means Global General. So you are not just general for Nigeria, from today you are general for Nigeria, Ghana, South Africa, U.S. It is my pleasure also to inform you that God decided for me to be part of this initiative. And it's equally my pleasure that whatever you do, once you find God, you will never ever fail. It's my pleasure to also inform you that we have similar issues which brought me closer to Cardinal John Anaika, who is the Catholic Archbishop of Abuja. One trouble was all over the country, 2011-12. We had the privilege of setting up a forum that we called Abuja Interfaith Peace Building Forum. Cardinal John Anaika inspired me to join him to establish the foundation for that forum. And up to today we are speaking, we are still making tremendous efforts to bring about understanding the Christians and Muslims. All that the evangelists said, all that Mama Gigi said, they are all in tandem with the Islamic teachings and principles. There is no difference. If you believe in God and you believe that tomorrow there will be a gift, then you should be good to your neighbor. And that neighbor, you have to count 40 houses on the right, 40 houses on the right, on the left, front and back. And for these 40 houses, no discrimination, whether they are Muslims or they are Christians, they are all your neighbors. So, as far as these issues of being humanitarian is concerned, we don't have any difference whatsoever. As any Islamic scholar, you will tell you this. So, what the evangelist is doing is in tandem with the Islamic teachers and ministers. And I believe God, in His infinite mercy, bless and bless and bless you. Please, those who join in prayer, please say amen. No, it's not enough. We're going to bless efforts of our evangelist. Let me agree with Mama Gigi. When she said that the widows that are here that help their children should take good care of their children, I think that is a piece of advice worth taking very seriously. Because we men, sometimes we are not good. Some men get closer to the widows because of what they think they possess. Not because of true love, and not because of true affection, either for humanitarian consideration or to take good care of the children, but simply because they are thinking that the husband died and left millions of millions of businesses. Own a chain of houses all over. So the poor man would want to come and marry you simply because he won't take benefit of that. So he also take a lot of that. Like he advised, be committed to your children. And remember that God Almighty is always there. By your side, he has you. With these implements, I would like to further associate myself with all the activities of this mission. Oh Allah, we pray that you continue to bless this foundation more and more. We pray that next year we'll have four times the number of beneficiaries at the end of this year. Finally, I say peace and love to all of you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
All right, thank you very much. To present the award, let's call on Brother IG, the founder of Rock of Ages Foundation. Please put your hands together for him.
On this day, 23rd of June, 2016, we are presenting this award to Elijah Jega as our Grand Veteran.
Occasion is taking place in the month of Ramadan. And one of the most important actions or acts that one can do in Ramadan is generosity, that is helping the needy ones. So, as evangelists, we are blessed all over. We are blessed all over. Because the Christians and the Muslims are going to benefit from this. And they are all there for you. So you are already blessed and you continue to be blessed and blessed and blessed.
All right, so without taking much of your time, let me not talk too much. Put your hands together for Alaji. Yeah, one day it will get to your turn too. You become grand patrons. Have you not been so? All right. Okay, without taking much of your time, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, to bring on stage this beautiful afternoon for another free will message, please, let's put our hands together for this beautiful woman. She is a former First Lady of Delta State, Justice. Alright, she is the former First Lady of our River State, Justice Mrs. Mary Orderly. Please put your hands together for her. Have you known that clap now? Alright, thank you very plenty. Maybe you won't go be another First Lady for Delta.
Mr. Expensive, my mother-in-law came from Delta State. Maybe that's why he decided to position me to Rivers, to Delta. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, women, oh yeah! Women, oh yeah! We are very happy to be here today. To be frank with you, when we came in, I just could not believe what I was seeing. The human beings filling up this hall, and then these provisions that must have cost a lot of money. To God be the glory. Yeah. Even though I was invited and I am part of this program, but I am representing the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Bamboni Mohammed. That tells you how important this program of Rock of Ages Foundation is. And that the work of God is the work for all human beings, no matter their position. The Chief Justice could not be here. He is out of the country, but the importance he placed on this program, he said, I should represent him. And so, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me deliver the short message he gave me with which he has identified with what is going on today. The remarks of the Chief Justice of Nigeria. I am happy to be part of the program of Rock of Ages Empowerment Foundation in commemoration of the Widow's Day. Celebrating the Widow's Day calls to mind this special group of our society who have lost their spouses. It may be a woman whose husband is demised, by which she acquires the status of widow. And in the case of a man who has lost his wife, he is a widower. This widowhood automatically restructures the living partner, thereby throws up various needs, such as financial, health concerns, and the care of the children, which otherwise was handled by two persons, now left in the hands of one, with the attendant challenges that are thrown up. The Rock of Ages Empowerment Foundation is to be commended for the interventionist role it has set up. Of interest is the fact that the foundation carries out research, meaning it is not operating in the dark as it carries out training and public educational campaigns about the needs for widows' empowerment and the girl child education. In all this, is the commitment to transform the lives of the underprivileged individuals through quality education, good medical treatment, and financial support, irrespective of age, gender, race, religion, or financial status. A category of persons that we cannot forget in this program, and those widowed but perceived to be in affluent surrounding, such individuals may not need financial assistance, but have the natural need of being accounted for as part of the living. In this relevance need, all they crave for would be, quote, brother or sister, how are you? I thought of you and decided to make contact, unquote. When this is done, you would have brought a ray of light and humanity in the life of another. I thank you for inviting me to be part of this compassionate project for humanity, geared towards commitment to service in the pursuit of a dream for meeting health needs, education and financial empowerment of the vulnerable poor and less privileged, particularly in our nation. We are happy to be part of this very noble enterprise, which Allah will definitely
the world.
Women, oh yeah! Women, oh yeah, yeah! Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. And don't forget, she's a Supreme Court judge. An award. Okay, ma'am. You like say you don't be grand matron too. So they don't ask you for your own name. Alright, and to present the award, Brother IG, if you like say you go allow Mama Gigi come present the award. Okay, madam, okay. Mama Gigi go present another one. Alright, Mrs. IG, we do the presentation. United Nations, she is coming to give us a free will message. Please put your hands together for her. Ah, clap for her, from the UN. UN. Put your hands together for her. Not the clap. Did she reach her? And don't forget to say the network service of Radio Nigeria and the transmit this thing live. Thank you.
Thank you.
I did you. How about it? Alright, carry on.
Good afternoon! How are you guys doing? Are you doing good? I just want to hear your voices. Are you doing good? A round of applause for yourself!
My name is Okoto Koko. I've been a journalist for some time, 20 years. Well, while they write United Nations there, we consult a lot for NGOs that come to United Nations. And I thank Evangelist Newman and Mama Joyce for fishing me here. When I heard his story, how he started, and I said, I'm right there in New York. I want to feel this day. Because for the past 7 years, I attend women conferences and other conferences in UN. A lot of NGOs do come. They represent Nigeria. They get money and they are sponsored by Nigerian government. I have not seen any of the NGOs display this kind of thing. So, when he told me the story, I said, I am there. I am going to be a voice to take him out there. And there's no darkness or silence that can cover this. He has help or not from anywhere. God has given him help to help him. I wrote a lot of things, but something happened last night. Adi, you helped me all because you were preaching here. Part of what I wanted to preach
you talked about it. You know, there are different categories of widows. She said, if you're a widow and you're getting this, you better use it very well. Because if you check Timothy 5, 3-16, there are so many categories of widows. Not every widow is entitled for something like this. But we are humans. When we want to give, when you say you are a widow, we do not discriminate. We do not go to the Bible to see which category you fall under. So as Mama G says, thank you, you know what I'm talking about. Whichever category that you fall into, and you receive this gift, please use it wisely. Our legal luminary, she defined widow. I don't have to go into that again. Because we have to grieve when it happens. But I'm happy that our legal section is here. Because most of these widows, they need legal help. When their husband dies, and their things are stripped from them, their properties, their husbands, they take everything away from you. And they say it's customary law. It is tradition that you have to accept. And they forgot that you have a child or children for that family. So they strip you naked of everything that you fought for. And you become a beggar. I know the case of one of my friends that comes to UN, Mrs. Joyce Ego. They took everything from her, and her best in-law was a front runner. She has to have legal help to fight and get certain things for her. Why my topic was to talk about empowerment of widows. But how do you empower widows? How many kinds of empowerment are we talking about? There is spiritual empowerment, because Mama Gigi said, and she prayed a lot here for you. If you have Holy Spirit in you, you better grab it. And as this says, Rock of Ages, it is there in the Bible. It is a song. And I don't know if you can give me that song. Rock of Ages, play for me. Let me hide myself with it. Thank you. So, when this happens, you need spiritual empowerment. You know what spiritual empowerment is? Yes. What do you do when you wake up? Yes. What do you do when your husband dies? Yes. Now, when they come for you and say, man, that house, that my brother has, what do they do? When you go to church, what do you do? What do you call that? That is spiritual empowerment. Because that is the time. If you were not brave before, and you know that your support has gone, you have to go on your knees and pray for God to uplift you spiritually. Because if you want to fight the battle alone, my dear sisters, I'm telling you, you'll be stripped naked. Because when you pray, God gives you the power, God gives you the wisdom, God brings you the favor, God brings you somebody like King Des, or all the bread. Did she manufacture bread? Did she manufacture soap? Did she manufacture clothing? Or Hesan? She did not. Spiritual empowerment, confidence, and obedience. Let her that do come and represent you free. I want you to have that knowledge today. In case you have problems from your families, from your husband families, inquire about it. It is there. So that they can come and represent you free. That is how Mrs. Joyce Depo got through her legal battle when she was almost stripped naked of her husband's property. Now, political empowerment. This is the time of politics. When the first lady is coming somewhere, the governor is going somewhere, they take all of you to line on the street to clap hands for them, to wave and shout, and you are happy. At the end of it, Rock of Ages is the only man, a private entity, that is celebrating International Widows Day. Newman for coming to represent your profession and the Chief Justice of the Federation, am I right? But you know, we have women in the House of Assembly. We have our senators. The men are married to us. The men, if you revolt against your husbands, if you are listening to me and fight for the rights of women, something will happen. The women in the legislature, please remember this. There are some states that have turned and had legislation for women, and I applaud those states. Please keep it up. So I am here today to tell you something. The woman that is sewing this machine is going to go home with the machine. In a week, she can get 40,000 naira. 40,000 naira, am I lying? If you are doing hair and us, you can make 20,000 naira. If you are your customer said you can make 60,000 naira. And I know you are going to employ other people. Are you not going to employ other people? The hairdresser is not going to be alone, she's going to employ people. The tailor is not going to be alone, she's going to employ people. When she employs people, there is a multiplication effect of employment going on around. So it becomes that private people, like the widows, are employing people. Next year, you are not going to come back to get this because you've already gotten it and you are going to employ more people. Then there's multiplication effect. The effect of poverty is going to go up. Sustainable development goal. This is sustainable development goal that you're doing. It does not have to be the government. Any other person can do it. And for you to do this, I think you can take your, we can take you over there to UN. Next month, we're going to do something about this. I call on all the millionaires in this country that putting their money in bank. down and bury their money, bring it out because there are women here that need your help.
That God can do, stay blessed as you watch.
All right, thank you very much.
Oh, since my husband left, things has not been easy.
Thank you.